Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan, and in this video, I want to talk about a trend that is kind of starting to happen for the next generation games. Whenever we transition from a console generation to the next console generation, there seems to be kind of what I call trends. You know, different developers seem to jump onto a concept, and this concept can be seen across multiple titles. And it's really similar to flying. The previous generation, for example, or this current generation of Xbox 360 and PS3 and the Wii, the trend really jumped onto the trend that was really heavily propagated to so many different games was the concept of cover-based shooting. Right? That was never a big concept in the days of PS2 and Xbox and GameCube. Most games did not even bother to do that, right? But now, that is totally a thing in this generation. The cover-based shooter. You know, Uncharted, Gears of War, Tomb Raider even. Tomb Raider never had cover-based shooting. What the heck happened, right? So that is a trend that happened in this generation. And I think, judging from this E3, I feel like what's going to happen in the next generation is this trend. That's a very important trend. I don't know how I feel about it currently. But it is really interesting that this is starting to happen, especially with the racing games. And the trend is that the line between multiplayer experience and single player experience is being destroyed or being erased or being blurred to the point where it can no longer be recognized as a line. It's really interesting how this is happening. And the games that I really want to bring to example are the racing games. Racing games like Forza Motorsport 5, Drive Club, The Crew, and Need for Speed Rivals all seem to go, they're all based on this idea that, you know, when you're playing a single player game, a human player could jump in to that single player experience and you could be cooperating together, like The Crew, you can be cooperating together to take down this other car that you're chasing, or you could be competing against each other. With like Drive Club, you have certain objectives with each checkpoint that happens, like drive faster than this speed, you know, on this corner. And if you do, you beat your friend. So you're kind of competing with another friend, even though that friend is offline right now. But he made that record. And that concept is actually something I experienced with an iPhone game, Real Racing 3, right? The time-shifted multiplayer component of Real Racing 3 kind of delves into that. It's really interesting to see this happening where to go from single player to multiplayer, I no longer have to quit the game, go back to the menu screen, and choose the mode, multiplayer mode, on that menu screen and to be able to play multiplayer. These games, the selling point of these games seem to be, you no longer have to do that. If you want to play multiplayer, you simply keep playing that game and somebody else will drop in and you'll be playing multiplayer. Now, this is not a totally new concept in the next generation, you know. A lot of games of current generation have been toying with this idea. Journey, downloadable title, have done this. Demon's Souls have been really kind of been toying with this idea. So it's not a completely new concept. But what I mean by trend is so many games are now starting to do this for the next generation. And I feel like it's a concept that's really only possible on the next generation consoles to this degree, because the computing power needed to make this possible can only really happen with these higher spec consoles. But I have to wonder if this is something that I want to happen, this destroying of line between single player and multiplayer. And that's really where I really kind of struggle to find an answer for, because it does sound awesome, right? It sounds pretty cool, and especially in driving games. Real Racing 3, the biggest problem I have with Real Racing 3 is that when I'm driving against, you know, passing by these computer-driven AI, it's so annoying that they do the same remote, there's a pattern that it's like a computer thing. Whereas with human players, they're unpredictable, they have different personalities, their driving style that they do. And so driving in a racing game, driving against other human players is so exciting, so awesome. So Forza Motorsport 5 having this feature, the Drivatar feature, which is using cloud-based, cloud-powered gaming, I don't know, marketing jargon there. I don't know what the hell that means, but basically it's kind of like AI, computer-driven AI, learns from human behaviors. It memorizes patterns that other human players do, and it adopts and it reacts so that computer-driven cars behave more like human-driven cars. That's awesome, actually. I think that's pretty exciting that Forza Motorsport 5 will do this. But I don't know if I want to totally embrace this concept of blurring the line between single-player and multiplayer. The reason is this, because, you know, when I play a single-player game, I expect it to be a single-player game, and I have clear expectations of what that feels like and what that experience is like. If I want to play a multiplayer game, I also have expectations of what that will be like. When you blur the line together, it's kind of like hard to be like, okay, today I'm just totally in the mood for being engaged in the story, moving forward, you know, these levels, and enjoying the experience that happens with scripted experiences or exploring the world that this game features in a single player way. I don't want to be bothered. I don't want to have to deal with other human players. And I know that single player experience makes it so that things are a little bit more predictable. I know what the enemy AI is going to do, and I want that. If I don't, if I want to kill time by engaging with other humans and having this crazy, totally unpredictable experience with multiplayer, I can totally just exit that single player and go into multiplayer and have that be its own separate mode. I'm at the point where I still appreciate that. But in a game like The Crew, I can't do that. Single player game is a multiplayer game, and multiplayer game is a single player game. The line is totally destroyed. And on the one hand, it makes the experience so much more engaging, right? Because I'm racing against cars that might be other human players. I might be cooperating with cars that might be other human players without having to do any matchmaking, without having to go to a lobby screen, without having to exit to a menu screen. That's actually really cool. But the cost is that I lose the ability to have a single player experience, just be single player experience, have a multiplayer experience, just be multiplayer experience. Is this something I want to give up? That's the question. Are all future racing games gonna be like The Crew or like Forza or like Drive Club? Is there gonna be any racing games in the future that allows me to just play single player and just play multiplayer like MotorStorm? And I like that. You know, when I play MotorStorm single player, I expect rubber band AI. I expect, you know, enemy AI that's more focused on destroying me rather than winning the race. If I go on multiplayer on MotorStorm, I know exactly what to expect with the multiplayer. These people are, I'm going to experience people who suck at the game, and I'm going to experience people who are just godly at that game and learn from them. But with a game like Crew, where that's disappearing. I don't know if I want that to disappear, even though if it disappears, games are going to progress to a new level. Now, I think this is your next-gen concept because something like this, a multiplayer happening with the single player happening in this universe without any kind of slowdown, without any kind of interruption, all this happening requires a lot of computing power, requires a lot of RAM, you know. So I think, and processing power. So with the CPU and the GPU, whatever. So I think this is actually a next gen concept. And with how AI is, I think this is actually only possible the way these driving games are meant to do, if they actually do what they promise to do. I don't think this is possible on the PS3 or 360. And so I think this is finally the next gen step to it. And it's not even only the racing games. Of course, it'd be wrong to say that this is only happening on the racing games. Destiny is going to do this, even though Destiny is also going to be available to play on the PS3. So that's going to be interesting how that's done on the current gen system. Tom Clancy's The Division is also embracing this concept of blurring the line between single player and multiplayer. So how this all plays out is it's going to be really interesting, but I am left with the question, would that actually be a really good thing? Is that actually something that I want to happen for the line to be destroyed between single player and multiplayer? I'm not sure. On the one hand, it does look awesome that this is going to be how things are in the future. I think it's super awesome to be able to play against another human player without realizing that he's a human player, because single player and multiplayer is kind of blurred right there. Amazing, right? But at the same time, I am kind of nostalgic to the ability to say, hey, this is a single player thing, and I'm gonna play single player. If I want to play multiplayer, I'm gonna exit out of this game, go to the menu screen, and go to the multiplayer. I think I might actually be nostalgic to that concept if this trend actually starts becoming much more prevalent in the next generation of consoles. I don't know. What do you guys think? Share with me your comments or PM me or whatever what you think on this topic. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Cheers.